Okay, first part done. Let us start with our session 2. Session 2 will be a little bit interesting because we have got biped. Okay, what is biped? Biped is a skeleton. Okay, so what is skeleton? Skeleton is the bone of your character. So whenever we see a character, actually our character is not animating in 3D. Our bones of the character is animating in 3D, and the ready-made bone structure in 3D Max is biped. Okay. So let us start learning for it. For that, first I will arrange this in a format. So I go to file here, click on save as, and now suppose I give a name 3, character 3. Okay. So now as I have modeled the object, I don't want this two box shapes here. Okay. I go to display, I click on unfreeze all, I just unfreeze the object, I select this box, I can delete it. Or if you don't want to delete, you think that it may be useful in future, just hide it. Okay, so this is you are hiding it temporarily, means Alt Q is just temporary hiding. If I just press on Alt Q again, it becomes visible, but hide selected means you have hidden it. So without Alt Q also your character will be visible. Okay, so now I am having my object like this. Okay, let us go to front view. What has happened is the character is facing that side. Okay, it is not facing front side. So what I do, I select this character and rotate it 180 degree. Okay, so now this is facing the front side. Okay, like this. So now this is my character. Okay, so what I do, I have to create a biped for this character. Okay, so for creating biped, what I have to do, go to create, go to this last option which is called systems. In the system I have got a last option which is called biped. Okay, so what I do, I select this character and press Alt X. Okay, so I have created an x-ray of this object. I go to display and I click on freeze selected also. That means I will not be able to move my object now. Okay, so why I have done this, because now I will be placing bones inside the object, and if this object is not freezed, when I will be selecting the bone, it will automatically select the character always. Okay, so that is why I have frozen this object. So now I go to biped. Okay, so in biped what I do, I just click and drag here. Okay, so now you get a biped. Okay, so this is a ready-made skeleton of a human object. Okay, so after creating the skeleton, it does not automatically get fit to our character proportion. You have to do it manually, because some character may be tall, some may be short, some may be of medium height. Okay, so accordingly you have to place your bones. So what I do, I go to the motion mode here. So whatever changes you have to do to a biped, you cannot do in modify mode. You have to do it in motion mode. Click on this motion. Okay, so after clicking on this motion, you get some options here like this. First is you have to go to this figure mode. Click on this figure mode, you get the figure mode. In figure mode, I go to this structure. Okay, under structure you have to define the links first. Like you are having a neck link 1. It is all right, because in a human being we have one neck. Spine links you are having 4. See, in a human being there are actually lot of spline links, but if I use lot of spine links here, my linking object will take lots of time and I don't need such details. So I just go for a 2 spine link, means I can just bend from here. Okay, I cannot bend my complete body like a particular object of more segments. So I just give 2 spline links. Leg links are already 3. It is okay. Okay, so then you are having tail links. I don't need tail links now. I don't need ponytail. I don't need fingers, because I have just roughly created it. I don't need finger links also. Toes, let it be like this. Toe links, reduce it to 1. I don't need props. These are all by default arranged. You don't have to change any of this. So when you are experimenting, you can just change and see what happens, but according to this human character, these are my settings. So then what I do, press F3, this point is called your pivot point. Okay, so if I tell you to select the pivot of an object, if I on this F3, I will not be able to see the pivot. Off this F3, you can see this pivot. Click on this pivot and then just move it to the center of the object. Okay, like this. This pivot should be somewhere here, like this. Now go to my left view, move and place it as you want, like this. Then what I have to do, let us arrange one by one. First let us arrange the legs. I select this portion of the biped. Okay, I go to the scale tool and I scale from a 2D angle, like this. Okay, like this. I select this leg here, go to the bottom. Okay, select this leg, go to this move tool and place the leg here. My height is very larger, go to this one, select and scale. See, now I have set my now it is not complete. Select this leg, go to this move tool, from the left view it is actually here. Okay, a little bit backward. Okay, like this. So now as you see, I have set my right leg. Now I want to set my left leg, which is exactly the opposite. So what I do is, I double click on this thigh of the leg here. I go to copy paste. Okay, here you have got posture, create a new collection. This is create collection. This is posture. Click on copy posture. Okay, then click on paste posture opposite. Now you can see this leg automatically got aligned according to this leg. Same process for this one. I increase the height of this spline, go to scale tool, I scale it little bit like this, I scale it little bit like this till the neck starts, like this. So till the shoulder starts, okay, like this. Here we will be able to know what mistakes we have done in the anatomy. Okay, suppose I place it like this. Then I select this hand tool, move it. I am using the shortcut W for move. Okay, my hands are small, select this one. I think my spine should be still a little bit smaller, like this. Yes, okay. Select this hand, scale it till it reaches the center point of the three divisions which I have done. Okay, this is my hand, scale it. Okay, just move it. Okay, you can move and scale it. Okay, so now go to the top view and check whether it has come from the center and in between the hands. Then click on this shoulder, double click, copy posture again and paste opposite, like this. So now see my whether my head is in the correct place. I think my neck is little bit longer. Go to this neck and scale it. Select this head and scale it. Okay, now I think I have fit my, see, don't think of the thickness of this hand, because this is just the skin. You your thickness of this bone doesn't depend on the object, so it can be thinner or it can be thicker also. Okay, it is just about the placement of the bones, which should be accurate, because once you have started your rigging process, and if you see that your positioning of your biped is wrong, at that time cannot do anything. At that time what you have to do, you have to completely start rigging from the beginning. Okay, so these are some constraints. Like after creating the complete model and complete rigging, you find that you need to do some changes with the polygons over here. Like you want to add a bulge or something, that you cannot do, because if you do, all your rigging will be congested and it will get corrupt. So before going to the rigging portion, you have to be 100% correct in your modeling. Okay, otherwise you have to do everything again. So now I have created my figure. So now I off this figure mode. After setting the figure according to the character, I off this figure mode. Okay, so now I again save this file. Okay, I have saved it as character 3. Okay, so now I just go here and save it as character 4, because I am keeping as much backups as I need. Okay, like this. Suppose I have saved it as character 4. So what I have done, this is the first part of rigging. Okay, so first part of rigging means placing the biped. Now what is my job? My job is to link this biped to the character. So I have frozen my character, so go to display here, click on unfreeze. So unfreeze the character. So click on unfreeze all. So my character has been unfreezed. So I have clicked on all text, so my object is looking transparent. So just keep it in all text. Okay, so now go to this modify mode. See, if you want to attach this object to this biped, what you have to do is you have to delete the mesh mode. In the mesh smooth mode, you cannot attach it to a biped. If you attach it, it will be a mistake. So delete this mesh mode. And again, in symmetry mode also, you cannot attach to a biped. It will create problems. So you have to right click and click on collapse all. That means all my character vertexes have been merged together. That means you don't have a symmetry identity now. That means if I change any vertex here, this will not change after collapsing. So this is the stage where you are totally final with the character. Okay, I have created it like this. So now what I have to do, I want to join my vertexes to this biped. Okay, so what I will do is, this is a very critical process. So look very carefully. So select this this character, not the biped. Select this biped, go to the modifier list, you will get a physique. PHYSIQUE. Click on physique. Okay, so you will get like this. Zoom to the pivot. Okay, like this. Click on attach to node. I click on attach to node and I click on this pivot like this. Computer will ask to initialize. Okay, so click on initialize. I initialized it. Okay, see, once you initialize it, what happens is, if I go to the leg of the biped, suppose like this, of the biped, not of the character. Okay, I click the leg of the biped and move it. So what happens? Okay, it is just dragging like a chewing gum. Why it is happening? Because the nearby bones are not attached to the leg. Okay, so now if I go and adjust each and every vertexes unknowingly, then it is very difficult for me to attach it. So what I will do is, I will expand this physique mode. I go to this vertex, select all the vertexes here. Okay, I select all the vertexes here. I click on remove from link. I click on remove from link and I just click and drag all the segments here like this. See, now all my vertexes has changed to blue color. See, what does this color indicate? See, red color indicates that your objects are deformable. Okay, blue color indicates that your vertex has not been attached to any object. And next you will have another brown color, which will indicate that one vertex is attached to one or more bones. Okay, so how to do it? I am showing it. You choose a polygon selection here. Okay, because I have to select vertexes, suppose from here to here. If I select it in a rectangle way, this portions will also get selected. Okay, so this is a hard working job. So just let us start from a leg. Okay, so what I do, I just click and drag up to here. Go to select, click and drag. I just select this much of vertexes. See, only this much of select vertexes are blue. Then what I do, assign to link and click on this red color line. So what has happened, this much of vertexes has been linked to this bone. Again go to select. Now I select the bone from here. See, as I taught you, we will link the middle bone. Okay, this is my middle bone. From here to here, I will link to this bone. Okay, then I will go to select. Then I will again select this middle bone from here to here, suppose. Okay, now I will assign to link to this bone. Okay, then I go to select. I will select from here to here. I I will assign to link to this bone. Then I will select from here to here, assign to link to this bone. Then I will select all the bottom bones here from here to here. I think I don't need to select the top one. From here to here, assign to link this bones. So now I have selected linked by legs. Now let us go to the top to the body. So now you just imagine if you will be linking finger wise, it is a very tedious job. You have to do it, but that is a very tedious job while learning. That's why I have ignored that. In future you will do it. Okay. So now I will select this objects, this parts only. This parts only. I will link it to this middle line like this. Okay. And this what this one and this one to this three lines here. Okay. Because these are cross connections. Then I select from here to here. See, here I needed a line, but I have not drawn it. Leave it. Okay. Assign to link. Select. Again, I select from. This is a very careful selection. You have to do it over here. Okay, from here to here. See, I select an extra vertex. Okay. Here I selected one line extra. Although it ends here, I selected one extra so that it will create a blend. Okay. Like this. Then I select this neck, okay. Neck I think from here to here. See, neck will create a problem. This I will have to select from left, okay. Let us select this shoulder. Okay, so this is my shoulder. Assign to link this one. Select again this one. Assign to link, this is shoulder, okay. So let us go by hands. After that we will go to that neck, okay, up to this one, okay. Assign to link this one, okay. So you don't need to be confused. It is only about the perfect clicking, okay. Otherwise the subject is not difficult, okay. Sometimes what happens is we select it here like this, okay, but we forget to go to assign to link and just click here. This will not work, okay. So that's why you have to practice it lot of time so that you can remember the exact steps. Okay. Assign to link this one. Select. Assign to link this one. Select. Assign to link this one. So what I did, I have not done my neck. Okay. So what I do, I go to the left view now. Because I think left view will be comfortable for linking the neck. Okay. Select, zoom it. Say in neck, what I have to do? I have to select only this much portion. Okay. Like this. Okay. Assign to link and I link to neck. Then I select my head portions, means from here to here. See, as I told, in the intersecting point, you have to link it to both the bones which are nearer to each other or joined to each other. Okay. So now we will check that whether we have skipped any vertexes or not. How can we check it? Go to the vertex and press Ctrl A, select all. If you find any blue vertex, then you can, then you will know that you have left that vertexes somewhere. See, there are some blue vertexes here. What I have to do is I have to select this blue vertexes one by one and see that which portion it fits. It fits the neck here. So assign to link, click on this one. Okay. Click on this vertex, go to select, press Ctrl A again. You see whether some more blue points have been left somewhere. I don't think any more blue points are left. If something is left, we can again add it in future also. Okay. Means you can add this point, not polygon adjustment. Okay. So now I go to physic mode. Okay. Now I select this object, press Alt X, I off this Alt X and I apply this mesh mode. Okay. So now here my rigging has been complete. I save the file. Okay. And my biped rigging is complete. See, it is not complete yet. Okay. Why? Because we have not checked it. Okay. So let us check it. Okay. So what I do, I select my leg here. not means the leg of the biped. Okay, now choose the move tool and just move it. Okay, so if it is perfectly moving, then it is okay. Then go to this motion mode. Okay, so I have selected this leg. I want to select this opposite leg. If I go and click on it, sometimes what may happen is it will not click on the leg but on the object. So here you are having a selection, select opposite. If I click on opposite, it will automatically select the opposite leg. See, now it is okay. Now I check the hand. Now just move it like this. Okay. Undo. Now select the opposite one. Now move it. Yes, it is okay. Now I select this spline. Spline cannot be moved, you just rotate it from left view. See, yes. Okay. So you have built your character and you have rigged it comfortably like this. See, always try to maintain fewer segments. Okay. So here I will tell you something about the theory. Okay. Don't go into complicated objects now. Okay. Your subject is about creating fashion communication designs. Okay, so and this is a part of it. If you involve in details of modeling now, you will not be able to concentrate on any other work. Okay, so try to keep it minimum as possible, because if you add more segments to it, the editing process of adding vertexes to biped will be very much complicated. It will not be as easy as I told here. It will be very complicated. Okay, so that's why you make a calculation of your time, and according to your time you create a complete object. Okay, it should not be that you want to create the best one and you end up doing nothing. Okay, so calculate your time and create the complete work as you can do. Okay, and if you are passionate about it, you can give extra time and go for detailing in future. Okay, so thank you. This is about rigging.